Hello, how are you all? I hope you all are fine and doing well. My name is Sayyeda Fatma Rizvi, and I bring for you people the very interesting and informative videos of physics. Today, we are going to study the subtopic of electrostatics, which is electric field intensity and the electric field. Like the gravitational field, we also have the topic like electric field, and like the gravitational field intensity, we also have the topic like electric field intensity. And we all know that they are linked with the charges, right? Like the positive charges and the negative charges. So we are going to study in detail today about the electric field and the electric field intensity. So we know about the field, that what is the field? The field is the area in which some sort of work is performed. So today we are dealing with the electric field and the electric field intensity. So let's start. So what is electric field basically? Electric field is the physical field that surround electrically charged particles, okay, and exerts force on the other charged particles in the field. Okay, so let's suppose if we have a positive charge and it exerts some sort of force. Let's suppose it exerts some sort of force on the other point charge. Let's suppose we have the point charge like the positive point charge. We always take the point charge as the positive charge. So let's suppose we have taken the point we have taken the positive charge and the point charge, and the positive charge will exert the force of repulsion on the other point charge, which is a positive charge. So the field surrounding that positive charge is known as the electric field. Okay, so electric field is a physical field that surrounds the electrically charged particles and exert the force on the other charged particles in the field. Okay, either it will be the force of attraction or repulsion, either attracting or repelling them. It also refers to the physical field for a system of the charged particle. Okay, so basically the field surrounding the charged particles is known as the electric field, and through which the charged particles here we have taken the positive charge, through which the charged particle exert the force of attraction or repulsion on the other point charge. Okay, so let's move further. Here we have taken the diagram, and we have taken the negative charge. First we have discussed about the positive charge, but here we have taken about the negative charge. So we are discussing over here the negative charge, and we have taken the other point charge as well. So here you can see that the force of attraction is created between the two charges because these are the opposite charges, and the field area surrounding that negative charge is known as the electric field. So we have discussed about the electric field in details. Now let us study about the electric field intensity. So what is intensity? Intense, something very intense. So electric field intensity at the point is the force experienced by a unit positive charge placed at that point. Okay, so like here we have discussed in the previous diagram. Let's suppose if the charge is placed, if the point charge is placed at some distance from the other negative charge, it means that the positive charge will experience the less force. But if the distance between the negative and the positive charge will decrease, it means that the positive point charge will experience more force. So it depends upon the distance between the negative and the positive charge. It means that the force will be greater on the unit positive charge if the distance between negative and positive charges are small. But if the distance between the negative and positive charges are large, it means that the force experienced by the positive charge will be less. Okay, so इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी इज एट द पॉइंट इज द फोर्स एक्सपीरियंस बाय द यूनिट पॉजिटिव चार्ज प्लेस एट दैट पॉइंट. इट मीन्स दैट वेन द यूनिट पॉइंट चार्ज इज ब्रॉट क्लोजर टू दैट ऑफ द नेगेटिव चार्ज एज वी कैन सी अवर हेयर. इफ द यूनिट पॉजिटिव चार्ज इज ब्रॉट क्लोजर टूवर्ड्स द नेगेटिव चार्ज, इट मीन्स दैट दिस पॉइंट चार्ज विल एक्सपीरियंस मोर फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन. ओके, द इंटेंसिटी विल बी ग्रेटर, द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी विल बी ग्रेटर. बट इफ द दैट पॉइंट चार्ज इज एट सम डिस्टेंस विद दैट ऑफ द नेगेटिव चार्ज, इट मीन्स दैट द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी विल बी लेसर. सो इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी इज अ वेक्टर क्वांटिटी, इज डिनोटेड बाई ई. ओके, सो इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी इज अ वेक्टर क्वांटिटी, इट मीन्स दैट इट हैज़ सम सॉर्ट ऑफ डायरेक्शन एज वेल, एंड इट इज़ डिनोटेड बाय द फॉर्मूला विच इज़ फोर्स पर यूनिट चार्ज. इट मीन्स दैट हाउ मच फोर्स इज एडेड ऑन द पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट चार्ज और यूनिट चार्ज. सो इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी इज डिनोटेड बाई ई एंड इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाई फॉर्मूला फोर्स पर यूनिट चार्ज एफ डिवाइड बाई क्यू. And it is a vector quantity. It means that if the electric field intensity is outwards, the force will also be outwards, and they are directly proportional to each other. So they are linked with each other. So here we see E is equal to F divided by Q. Let's come towards the unit of that electric field intensity. E is equal to Newton per Coulomb. So if we want to discuss further that how much force is exerted on the charge placed at the specific point in the electric field, we represent it by the formula F is equal to Q multiplied by E. That how much force is exerted on the particular charge placed in the electric field. So the force is given by the formula F is equal to Q multiplied by E. So here you people see in the figure that we have the point charge and the positive charge. We have the point positive charge and we have taken the negative charge in the center. So you people see the electric lines of four forces, electric field intensity, and these electric field intensity are represented by the lines, these lines. So the two charges obviously will experience the force of attraction, and the force of attraction is represented over in the outward direction as the electric field intensity is represented in the outward direction. So you people see that these charges will experience the force of attraction because these are the two opposite charges and electric field intensity are moving outwards. So electric field intensity have some different patterns. Yes, you people see in the figure that if we take the positive charges, so these two positive charges will represent will repel each other, and the electric field intensity are represented by some lines, electric lines, as you people see in the figure. As we have taken the two positive charges, the two positive charges are the like charges, and through the positive charges the electric lines of forces go outwards, and through the in case of negative charges the electric lines of forces move inwards. So in case of positive charges, as we have two positive like charges, so it means that both charges are repelling each other, and you people see the pattern over here. In case of two opposite charges, it means that the greater force of attraction is created, and you people see the electric field intensity in case of the opposite charges is shown in the figure. In case of the isolated charges, the electric field intensity in case of positive charge is given in that figure. The electric field lines are moving outwards. In case of the negative charge, the electric field lines are moving inwards. Here the different pattern of the electric field intensity is given. In case of two positive charges, the electric field intensities are repelling each other, are represented by the lines. And in case of opposite charges, the electric lines of forces there is a force of attraction between the two opposite charges, and you people see the pattern of electric field intensity in case of two opposite charges. The direction of electric field intensity in an electric field can be represented by drawing the lines. As we have seen in the figures, in the different figures, we see that the electric field intensity can be represented by drawing lines. These lines are known as the electric lines of forces, and these lines were introduced by Michel Faraday. So basically it is a pattern, and the electric field intensity are represented by drawing the lines, and these lines are known as the electric lines of forces, and these lines were introduced by the scientist who is known as the Michel Faraday. The field lines are the imaginary lines around the field charge with the arrowhead indicating the direction of force. So obviously the electric field intensity is linked with the force. So these imaginary lines, these field lines are known as the imaginary lines around the field charge with the arrowhead indicating the direction of force. So let's come towards the property of electric field intensity. Field lines always move away from the positive charge but towards a negative charge. So we have seen already in the diagram that the field lines move away from the positive charge but towards the negative charge. Is the natural property of electric lines of forces that they move away from the positive charge but towards the negative charge. Field lines are related to electric field intensity in any region or space. Okay. It means that if the electric field intensity is larger, if the field lines are larger, so the electric field intensity will be larger in that case. If the field lines are lesser in case of the positive or negative charge, so the electric field intensity in that region or space will be less. Electric field is strong when the field lines are close together and weak as they are far apart. It again the same thing. Electric field is strong when the field lines are close together. It means that the field lines are larger and linked with each other and are close together. It means that the electric field is strong in that case and weak when they are far apart. No field line cross each other. So this is all about the electric field and the electric field intensity. I hope that you people enjoy the video. Please do like, share and subscribe to my channel and spread my videos worldwide. Thank you so much and Allah Hafiz.